Good afternoon and welcome to Audio Tree Live. Today is Saturday, July 28, 2012. We're very, very blessed to have in the studio with us Fang Island.
Choppers. Choppers.
Blend of Social Distortion, Exodus, and Boston or something. Beautiful, you guys. That was awesome. Incredible. I'd love to hear from each of you in regards to your earliest musical memory. When you were a child, first thing you remember about music. First thing you'd like to share.
First thing I remember is listening to Madonna's Something to Remember album. Still one of my all-time favorite records.
Man. Yeah.
With my parents.
Nice. It was like in the car? Was that actually
in the car,
at the house and stuff?
Driving to school, listen to Chris Isaac and Madonna.
Dope. Yeah. Wicked Game,
Wicked
is it?
Games.
Yeah, dude. Nice one, Chris.
Thank you.
Dope. How about you, Jason?
I remember having Green Day's Dookie at summer camp. I mean, that's sort of a go-to, but something about it at summer camp on tape was pretty impactful.
Was that the summer it came out, too?
It probably was, yeah.
And that when that thing came out, it, like, flipped the script on all that stuff,
yeah.
Didn't it?
I had an older brother, too, so he helped with that kind of stuff. I might have been
hip.
A little too young. Yeah, he was a little hipper.
That's cool.
He was fourth grade. I was second grade. Way
that's
hip.
That's why we have the siblings, you know. They can kind of guide us, hopefully, down the right path.
Exactly. The Dookie path. As I refer to it.
Post-Kerplunk. How about you, Joshua, man? What about you?
I would say Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
On TV. I don't know if it was like MTV or whatever it was, but Michael Jackson dancing to it. I kind of lost my skills, but I'm trying to get them back. So.
Hey, man. It's never gone, dude. Just hibernating. You got to bring
exactly.
that. Get the groove back. It'll come out. Dope. Michael Jackson. Never go wrong with that. How about you, Ryan, man? Earliest musical memory?
Maybe seeing Huey Lewis with my mom when I was like 5 or 6.
Dude, Huey Lewis?
Yeah.
Was that on the sports tour?
I think it was...
Or would that be
a little
later than that?
Be a
maybe,
little later.
Maybe 4?
Post-sports. Post-sports.
Did they do, like, all the hits, though?
I couldn't say, but I recall it.
The Power
of Love.
Remember
A Man in the Suit.
Yeah.
Far Away.
Dude, where was that gig at?
Somewhere in Maryland.
Dope. Huey Lewis, man. Shit. All right, Mark. Earliest musical memory?
Probably getting down to the Batman soundtrack. Prince.
Yeah, the Prince Batman soundtrack.
Yeah, I was obsessed.
That was some gear, right? Remember Jack Nicholson was dancing around?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
That was another level. Was that the 80s or was that like early 90s?
89.
Yeah. 89. Starting to blend. Thanks for being here, y'all. We're in the studio with Fang Eyeless. It's wicked. Audio Tree Live. Beautiful, you guys.
Thank you.
Hey, congratulations. Your fourth release, your second full-length album came out this week.
Yeah.
Congratulations on that, you guys. Major. Can you talk a little bit about that recording process and the writing process for that record?
The writing process for that record, let's see. I don't know.
Riffs on riffs?
Yeah, just riffs on riffs. We wanted to do a couple of popular songs, a couple of different things that aren't usually what we did in our old catalog.
Nice.
But
did you record it any differently? The writing seems like you guys are writing the same as you ever have. Did you record it a little different?
We went to the same studio that we have always gone for all of our records. We like working with those guys. It's called Machines with Magnets. It's in Pawtucket, Rhode Island.
Dope.
So we've done all of our stuff there, and we really trust them and have a good relationship with them. And we just try to do new things within the same sort of scaffolding, I think. And we're pretty psyched.
Dope, man.
Yeah.
It's good when you can find a home like that where you can always go and you know they'll take care of you.
Yeah, and we like stay there, and it just like feels like, again, not to bring up summer camp again, but it kind of feels like summer camp, staying there, waking up in the sleeping bag and just like going to play guitar.
Right, making bead bracelets and going water skiing.
Yeah,
it's a fantasy world.
Speaking of like new records and complete records, what's your most favorite album front to back, each of you? This changes for me every day. I know it's sort of a tough question, but what's your favorite album front to back today?
That is tough.
We'll start with you, Mark. We'll start over here on Mark here.
Oh, that's unfair.
My bad, Mark. You were last time. We'll go first this time.
Right now, and it always does change, I've been listening to this band Ulver. It's called Beltsander. It's like an acoustic.
They're called Beltsander?
That's the name of the record.
Oh, my bad.
I'm probably pronouncing it wrong, but the group is called Ulver.
Dope.
Ulver, yeah. And,
dope.
It's a cool record.
I got a hip to it. I've not heard that. I got to check it out.
Yeah.
Nice. Thanks, Mark.
My favorite record front to back would probably be Steely Dan's Asia.
Oh, right.
I think it's a perfect record. It's perfectly produced and perfectly played.
I think you took Jason's answer.
Well, I was going to say Pretzel Logic, so I'll just go with Pretzel Logic. I'm more of a Pretzel Logic dude. He's more of an Asia dude.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Steely Dan was big for us on this recording. Yeah. We listened to a lot of Steely Dan.
Nice.
A big inspiration.
A lot of ideas called from the Dan.
Yeah.
Are you with the Nightfly too? You like Donald Fagen's gear as well?
Yeah.
Chris does.
I like some of that stuff. We like
it's pretty goofy.
Yeah.
Right on.
You got one, Josh?
How about you, Josh?
Megadeth, Rust in Peace.
Yeah, awesome. Dude.
It's heavy. It's mean. It's technical. Some people don't like Dave Mustaine's vocals. A lot of people don't like that, but it's awesome. It's a good record.
Dave Mustaine's a polarizing cat, isn't he?
Yeah.
I must admit, I do like the P. Sells Who's Buying record. That record is insane.
Rust in peace, man.
He's like, no, dude. Rust in peace.
Dope.
How about you, Ryan, man? Most complete record album?
I would say Steve McQueen by Prefab Sprout. It's got to be Day to Day.
Yeah.
A hush went over the studio.
Produced by Thomas Dolby. It's just perfect.
Check him out. He's digging in the crates. Love it. Thank you, Ryan. We got a whole new playlist here, man. I got some Discovery. I gotta go listen to Rust in Peace again. We're just going to hook it up today. You know, Steely Dan, of course. That's always there. Thanks, you guys.
Thank you.
It's really dope having you in here.
Yeah, thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Audio Tree Live. Hells yeah.
One guy. One digital guy likes that song.
All right, we've made our way to the psychoanalytical portion of the session.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I'd love to hear from each of you in regards that if you had to choose a life form other than human, what life form would you choose to be? And that includes animals, oceans, forests, animal, vegetable, mineral type of vibe. We can use
that
our...
We get to be personally and then none of our friends are? Like, what's the deal? Like,
hey, you know what, Jason? You can create any world. If you want to be a penguin with and all your friends are penguins too, I'm down.
See.
You know, like, I'm down.
I think I'd go with blue whale.
Yeah.
Can't mess with that, in my opinion.
And all your friends would be in the pod of blue whales?
No, they're normal humans.
Oh, okay. Blue whale. Where would you be? Would you be like New Zealand?
That's the thing. No one knows where they are. So I can't even begin to. I don't want to presume to know.
No problem.
But
my fault to pry. I'm sorry.
It's okay. I mean, it's all right.
Blue whale, Jason. All right.
Not that.
How about you, Chris?
I want to be Magneto.
Yeah. There you go.
Wait
Magneto.
A minute. Now I'm a blue. I didn't know it could be X-Men villains.
Now. Do you have a thing against X-Men, or you just want to be the powerful
I wanted to be Magneto. Okay, I'm going to be Magneto.
You could be Colossus, Jason, if you want, or something like that.
sorry, I just hulked out a second there. Well, Colossus and Magneto are bros now, so.
Shibuya. So
I'm totally down with that. I almost swore.
All right.
I almost swore about Colossus.
How about you, Josh, man? What would you be?
I like cats.
Yeah. Like a house cat?
Yeah, but indoor, outdoor. And they got to feed me raw meat. I don't want that.
You mean wet, not dry?
No, I don't want that baloney that they have, that dry food.
Who's they? Your keepers?
The general populace of cat owners feed them crap. I want raw meat and outdoors, and they just relax, man. They're just so loose.
Yeah.
You know, I love them.
What kind of cat would you be color-wise? You have a preference?
Black.
You'd be a good luck black cat, Joshua. I'm feeling that. Yeah. Nice. All right, Ryan, how about you, man? Life form other than human?
I would be the ocean, and the entire world would feel my embrace.
Yes. Yes.
Ryan stole my answer.
But he's messing with that. Like, the Earth is 70% water, we're 70% water, and you're 100% of the water.
Yeah, wow.
You flow through.
I was expecting a mic drop.
Ryan.
We can drop these, right?
Yeah, we can say something like that.
We
can go around again.
We can destroy your equipment. Yeah, all right.
How about you, Mark, man?
Josh stole my answer.
So. You guys can be cat bros.
No. I think we could be dueling cats.
Ah.
Yeah. I don't know.
Or cat enemies.
Or you could be like a lion or a tiger.
No, I want to be a cat.
Small cats is the theme.
Like house
cats.
Big
cats.
Yeah, man. House cats got it good.
I'll be a panther.
Yeah.
I mean...
I'm with it.
Smoothie pea.
We're in the studio with Fang Island, and we're learning their other life forms. Thanks, you guys.
Thank you.
Dig it. Park Fest, just a few hours of tonight over there around the corner from us. Everybody in Chicago, get your ass into the city and make it happen. You guys got one more for us?
Sure.
Please, let's hook it up, man. We're in the studio with Fang Island. I can't let you
go.
Thank
you so much for having us, Audio Tree. Thank you.
Thank you, Chris. Awesome. Thank you, Jason, Joshua, Ryan, Mark. Thank you guys so much.
We'll be right back.
Maryland Audio Tree Live. Tyrannosaurus Riffs. That was some shit.
Thank you.
Unbelievable. Thank you. Let's give thanks here to our video crew here, Northwoods Revolution.
Thank you guys.
Our audio engineers today, Jake and John, Michael and Kellen in the house. Not to mention your roadie, Sean. Let's give him a grind. You know, he's helping you out. Much love. Jason, Chris, Josh,
legendary roadie.
Ryan, Mark. Thank you guys so much. We've been in the studio today with Fang Island. It's been awesome. Thanks, guys.
Thank you so much.
Here, man. Go check these cats tonight at Wicker Park Fest. They're playing at 7:30 tonight right around the corner from us, and pick up the new record called Major. This has been Audio Tree Live for Saturday, July 28th, 2012. We've been in the studio with Fang Island. My name is DJ Evil Vince. Everybody have a very safe and beautiful day.
Thank you.
Good day.
You too. Thank you. Thank you, guys.